A new robot vacuum brand with a high-end model that can suck, mop, automatically empty the dustbin and wash and dry its own mops at a price which undercuts its main competitors is Robotec R7 Max. Any good? Let's inspect. So, I'm gonna be very honest with you up front. Well, I've heard about Robotec, the company staying behind this robot vacuum, for the first time a couple of months ago after they've sent me an email asking to review it, and then they've shipped me this sample. Well, technically it has the other half of this setup in the other room. I'm gonna show it in a moment. So if you think of this as being a sponsorship, so be it. But as usual, as I'm expecting cool tech here on the channel, I would stick to my usual kind of testing framework, putting this robot among multiple tests so that you can see all the good and strong sides, but also we can expose all the negatives and problematic areas so that you can make a good, educated decision whether that's a right choice for your best home cleaning buddy or not. And great to meet you, by the way. My name is Michael, the Tech Mishka. I invite you to subscribe because we do a lot of cool tech inspections and I feel exploring technology is quite fun these days. And now, let's put on the spotlight the Robotec R7 Max. Being the first in their portfolio, this is a very solid beginning with all these remarkable specs that are being promised with the R7 Max. While in terms of characteristics, my initial thought is that it is on par with the best from Roborock, D-Bot and so on, I'm lately quite conscious with new brands entering the robot vacuum market. A bit of a side research made me stumble across a few interesting conclusions, and to me it is still not quite clear whether Robotec stayed behind the entire R&D process or they have been using OEM services. It's not that important, however, might have an impact on the amount of firmware updates, a topic I'd love to cover as soon as we get to explore the smartphone app. Unboxing the unit is pretty good experience. Well, truth is that I was expecting another extra box inside this pack, but of course, wasting less materials does good to the nature. Plus, everything is really well protected. We begin by checking this excellent quick start guide. It's more of all that you need to know at a glance. Then comes the section with accessories. I underline that most of these are spares, because as you can notice after going to the next compartment, the robot is already equipped with a side brush, a HEPA filter and mops. R7 Max comes with a trendy silicone mid brush, Roborock and others have switched to this for their top-end models, significantly reducing the amount of tangled hair, and also this particular brush has quick-release sides for easily removing and cleaning all sorts of hair. You can notice all the sensors on the front and around, as well as the quite slim design that doesn't have any lidar on top, unlike many other high-end devices. Oh, we also get a little bottle with this cleaning solution included. You can add from this liquid to the clean water tank, and here's a close-up of the label so that you can take a note of the ingredients in case you're too curious. Last but not least, let's take out the base station. It contains three compartments. There's a clean water tank. This is where you have to regularly add some fresh water, which then the station feeds to the robot or uses for washing the mops pads. There's a dirty water tank, which is made of antibacterial material and stores the dirty water, as you may guess. When this tank gets full, you get notified. And the third section is where you're going to see the dust bag. As soon as it's full, you replace it with one from the set. As soon as you run out of these dust bags, you can order more from Robotec's website. Before we dive into the testing phase, I'd like us to talk about the specs and set the right kind of expectations. Robotec promised suction power up to 6000 pascals, maximum working time of up to 300 minutes, maximum cleaned area of 350 square meters. It has a 300 milliliter dust container, 80 milliliter water container, inbuilt camera, 3D AI sensor setup for precise navigation and mapping. The noise levels should not exceed 80 decibels in maximum power mode. And it has inbuilt Wi-Fi for smartphone app controls. So the maximum suction power of 6000 pascals, that's pretty amazing. Just know that it's not going to use the maximum during the whole time of cleaning, of course, unless you specify it via the app, because most of these robots traditionally go for the balanced mode, which is going to suck with a bit less, However, that's going to be way more than enough in most cases for collecting dust and small particles from your home. I think design-wise, this looks pretty amazing. I'm really excited about testing these mops. I think the main brush has pretty much the perfect kind of design, or at least it's following all the trends that we can see lately in most of its competitors. And I like the fact that it has just a single side brush, because I know that some people would believe that having two side brushes is the better option, but based on all of the tests that I've performed on the channel, you can see some of the older robot vacuum reviews, I feel that if we have two side brushes, this may sometimes push away some of the particles. Therefore, with a single side brush, cleaning ends up being a bit more optimal, especially concerning such kind of environment where you want to lift up rice grains and similar. On the top, I think this is the area which concerns me a little bit. Well, as a starter, we have a pretty nice magnetic cover, and this is nice to have. I feel that the dust box, being 300 milliliters, is, well, a bit small for the good 2024 best practices. And also, quite obviously, on the top, we don't have a LiDAR sensor, which most of the high-end robots use for good and accurate mapping of the rooms where they clean. In here, Robotec managed to integrate the LiDAR on the front, so it's kind of hidden, and the purpose is to make some gains about the height. So now I'm really curious how good or bad they are about room mapping, multi-map setups, and also avoiding obstacles and crashes. But I think we should start testing the usual way, spilling 60 grams of rice and figuring out how much out of that the robot is going to bring back.
The R7 Max passes the rice test with A, because it managed to bring in most of these grains back. Note that with all of these tests, I've used the auto and the standard modes, unless otherwise stated. And apparently, if you go to the max suction mode, which is a bit noisier, R7 Max is going to do even better than that. Next, we want to increase the complexity and the texture of the artificial dirt. We would add some flour, seeds and other particles, so that we check what would happen. And yeah, it's a very convincing result. Furthermore, with the ability to cover an area twice for a particular cleaning task, I feel that for the Robotec device, this is quite an easy task. Apparently, the main station is going to, well, empty all this dirt from the bin as soon as the robot parks. You may have to do this on a more regular basis, because the 300 milliliter capacity in the main body is rather not that generous. Since there's a mid-brush, this robot is perfect for houses with pets, because it will easily collect hair even from carpets, let alone wooden floors or tiles. Speaking of carpets, with unspecified climbing ability, it easily goes on top of the carpets and by default relies on the so-called carpet boost mode, where it automatically raises the motor power so that it can perform deeper kind of cleaning. From within the smartphone app, I've noticed two particularly useful functions, the fine cleaning mode and the corner cleaning mode, both of which are going to make the tasks take a bit longer time, but improve the overall efficiency. Concerning obstacle avoidance, especially about smaller objects, such as cables, socks and stinky bombs, watch carefully. Robotec speak proudly of their mopping function. It's among the very well-performing robots about wet mopping, maybe among the best that can do combined dry and wet cleaning. Speaking of which, you can mix these modes the way that you prefer. Dry cleaning only, or mixture of both, or only mopping, or mopping after the dry cleaning has been performed, and given the fact that in most cases power consumption seems to be a bit more than 0.5% per square meter, I can only say positive things about the battery endurance. Doesn't really feel the same way with the smartphone app though. You can choose between the Tuya Smart and the Smart Life app, both having nearly identical features. And seeing the fact that the robot is referred to as just R7 Max makes me think that it lacks this custom touch and feel that you may get through a branded, dedicated smartphone app, something that hopefully is going to appear at some point. Overall, the app feels good, controls and features are plenty, however, mapping is not that remarkable, especially if we put it side by side with some of the champions in this league. You can make enough adjustments on the robot performance though, and all the features are well grouped and easily accessible. And you can even use a camera, another strong reason to get R7 Max if you have pets at home. And before someone says something about lack of privacy, there is a physical button. Shut it off and it's gone.
Camera is off.
Traditionally, before the wrap-up, I'm having a few pointers about drawbacks or imperfections. Maybe, if R7 Max was equipped with a LiDAR on top, it would have been slightly quicker about mapping and movements, was about to be not that slim, though. The multi-floor map implementation is not that great yet, and the map details are not as detailed as those on the Roborock S-series. Also, I couldn't find a kit for connecting your base station to the water pipe system at your home.
I feel that the test results are quite conclusive, and obviously the R7 Max has the capacity to handle even a lot more serious situations in terms of cleaning, and I'm really happy to say that it really delivers all the things that Robotec promised it is capable of. Very reliable, very strict. Some remarks about the mapping, but the overall cleaning performance is superb. I really wish it had a branded dedicated smartphone app, hopefully something about to come, because if it does, pretty sure that combined with the 5-year warranty, which is insanely good, that's gonna be a terribly good deal to miss. And yeah, in many ways, exceeds the expectations, probably in some areas better than the competition, at a more attractive price. And you know pretty well that this is a very good working success formula. So that's my take on the R7 Max. If you have questions or requests so that I test something for you, let me know in the comment section below the video. If you're on the hunt for a robot vacuum, check the description. And thank you very much for watching this episode. Subscribe to the channel for more cool tech inspections, and maybe you can become a channel member if you want to support me in my journey to explore more cool tech. Thanks very much for watching. I'm the Tech Mishka. Gotta see you soon. Bye.